Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 24, featuring Raymond Burr, Peter Lorre, James Mason, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
Sound off for Chesterfield. Chesterfield is best for you. First cigarette with premium quality in both regular and king size. Chesterfield brings you Dragnet.
Ladies and gentlemen, the story you're about to hear is true. The names have been changed to protect the innocent. You're a detective sergeant. You're assigned a robbery detail. You get a call from the San Diego Police Department that three holdup men are thought to be heading for your city. You know they're armed. You know they're dangerous. Your job, get them.
Years ahead of them all.
Chesterfield is years ahead of them all.
The quality contrast between Chesterfield and other leading brands is a revealing story.
Recent chemical analyses give an index of good quality for the country's six leading cigarette brands. The index of good quality table, which is a ratio of high sugar to low nicotine, shows Chesterfield quality highest.
Chesterfield quality highest.
15% higher than its nearest competitor.
Chesterfield quality highest.
31% higher than the average of the five other leading brands.
Yes, Chesterfield is first with premium quality in both regular and king size.
Don't you want to try a cigarette with a record like this? Chesterfield.
Dragnet, the documented drama of an actual crime. For the next 30 minutes, in cooperation with the Los Angeles Police Department, you will travel step by step on the side of the law through an actual case transcribed from official police files. From beginning to end, from crime to punishment, Dragnet is the story of your police force in action.
It was Monday, October 5th. It was warm in Los Angeles. We were working the night watch out of robbery detail. My partner's Frank Smith. The boss is Captain Didion. My name's Friday. I was on my way into the office, and it was 4:58 p.m. when I got to room 27A. Robbery. Hi, Murph. Seen Frank?
Yeah, he was here a couple of minutes ago. I think he went down the hall, said he'd be right back.
Thanks. How are the kids?
Yeah, we're in the cycle again.
What do you mean?
Yeah, the cold cycle.
Oh, yeah.
Oldest boy brings one home with him, gives it to his sister. Then it goes to the baby, then to the wife, and then to me. By the time I got it, the oldest boy's ready to catch it again from me. Doesn't seem to be any end to it.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Reading the other day where if you take care of a cold, you know, take a lot of pills, stay in bed, you can shake it in a week.
All right.
Don't do anything special for it, and it'll take 7 days to get rid of it.
Joe? Got an APB here from San Diego. Boys down there really drew themselves a gem.
Yeah, can I take a look?
Yeah, here he is.
Well, I can hear him moan all the way from here.
What is it?
Well, I had a jewel robbery at a hotel on the coast. Three men, took $135,000 in jewels and at least $15,000 in cash.
$150,000, huh? Any leads on them?
No, APB gives a description, list of the stolen jewelry. That's about all.
When did it happen?
It says 1:30 this morning.
Yeah, it's going to keep him busy for a while. That Mort's screaming like an eagle, Joe.
Why?
Well, I talked to him last week, said he was going down to Mexico to do some fishing. Been saving days off for the last 3 months. Won't get to go now.
Yeah, I get it. Robbery, Friday. Yeah, go ahead. San Diego.
Huh?
Yeah, hi, Mort. Yeah, we got the APB. How's it going? Yeah. When do you figure they left? Yeah. Okay, Mort, yeah. All right, we'll keep an eye open. Right, bye.
What's he got?
Well, Davis, Walk, and Hewen are coming up.
They're driving?
Yeah, they figure the holdup men are heading this way. The early editions of the afternoon papers came out, and they carried the complete story. Three men had entered the Carlton Surf Hotel at 1:30 a.m., all three were armed, and they forced the manager to open the safe. Inside the vault were the jewels and the other valuables that had been deposited with the management for safekeeping by the guests. After looting the safe, the three men had robbed five of the guests who had entered the lobby during the time that they'd been going through the safe. After taking all the money and valuables they could find, the three men forced the manager and the guests into a back storeroom of the hotel, and they locked them in. None of the victims could tell the San Diego officers what kind of a car had been used, but all of them were able to give good descriptions of the three men. The San Diego Police Department had been called, and the men from the Detective Bureau had begun an immediate investigation. From the phone conversation I'd had with Lieutenant Mort Gear, they had evidence to believe that the three men were heading up for Los Angeles. While the three detectives from the San Diego Department came to L.A., Lieutenant Gear, Sergeant Tony McGuire would continue the investigation down in their city. 11:12 p.m. Sergeants Carl Davis, Jerry Walk, and Pappy Hewen arrived at the city hall. They filled us in on what had happened.
The way the thing looked, it figured that someone who had either worked for the hotel or was working for it had engineered it.
How'd that check out?
The identification we got?
Yeah.
Virgil Russell worked for the hotel a year ago as a busboy in the dining room. All the victims gave a positive identification on him.
Well, how about the other two, Carl?
Nothing on him, yeah.
What made you figure they might be coming up here?
Well, Russell's got a record, checked his package, and found that he has a sister in San Diego. Checked her, and she gave us the lead.
Yeah.
Said her brother and two men came by the house early this morning. Her brother's been staying with her for the past few weeks. Anyway, he came by this morning, packed his clothes, said he had to come up to L.A. on business.
Well, she have an address up here for him, Carl?
Not good. Said he told her he'd get in touch with her. He was staying with a friend place out on Olympic Boulevard.
Anything on that address?
Yeah, our package gave an address out there. Russell had listed a friend of his when he was arrested. We figured he might be out there. Got a good description of the car. One thing is going to help.
Yeah.
Sister told us that she asked her brother about the other two men. Wanted to know if they didn't want to come to the house.
Mm-hmm.
Russell said no, they were waiting for him. If the three of them were in a hurry, she couldn't give us a description of the other two.
Well, what time this happened?
About 5:30 this morning.
Huh. Well, they came right up here. They'd get in about 8 then, wouldn't they?
Yeah.
You're pretty sure that these are the right ones now?
Looks like that. Identification of the mugs. Russell's sister told us when he was packing, a brooch fell out of his grip. She picked it up for him.
You have a description of it?
Yeah, matches one that was taken from the hotel in the theft. Large diamond with 4 rubies in the setting. Looked real good for the job.
Did you get a broadcast out on the car?
Yeah, Russell's sister told us it's a 53 Nash, red and black Continental hookup. She said Russell just got back from a trip through Arizona, Nevada, New Mexico. Said that he had the rear window covered with those stickers. You know, the ones they get from gas stations.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Window's supposed to be covered with them. Shouldn't be hard to spot.
Well, maybe he figures that, too. Might have him taken off, huh?
Possible. It's a lead, though. Something else to look out for.
Any chance he might have gotten across the border into Mexico?
Yeah, it's possible, but it isn't likely. As soon as we got word on the car, we got out a supplemental APB on it and got in touch with the authorities down the border. They said they hadn't seen a car that matched the description across the border.
Well, if they'd gotten to the border, the officers down there'd know about it anyway.
Yeah, I talked to Al Gayton from our office. He said they'd be on the lookout for him.
Our pawn shop detail got right on it, Carl. They got the description of the jewelry out all over town. We haven't had any reports on it yet, though.
They aren't going to try to sell it piece by piece. Too many of those pieces are easy to recognize.
Yeah.
They'll probably try to peddle through a fence and have it broken up.
Well, we'll get the word out to our informants. Ask them to watch out for it. Yeah. Heist that big can't be kept quiet for long. Bound to be rumbles on it someplace.
I'd like to check out the place on Olympic. It looks like it's the best lead we got.
Okay. We're walking Hewen, you know.
Went down the hall with Murphy. Wanted to check some things at R&I.
Well, might as well get on out to Olympic, huh? You got the address?
Yeah, you better check the place first. Could be rough.
What do you mean?
Well, all three of them are armed. Russell served time twice before at the joint.
Yeah.
I don't think he's going to want to go back.
We checked the name of Russell's friend through our files. We found that he had no record. We drove out to the address on Olympic and we talked with the neighbors. From them, we found out that it was not a private residence. We talked to the woman who lived next door. We asked her about the man listed in the San Diego package as a friend of the suspect's. She told us she hadn't seen him. Directly in front of the rooming house, we found a car answering the description given us by the sister. There were no lights on in the rooming house. Walk and Hewen covered the rear of the place. Frank, Carl Davis, and I went up to the front door.
Pretty dark. I can't see anybody in there, can you?
No, I can't.
Check the window, see if I can spot anything.
Right, Carl. Now let's try the door.
Yeah.
Who is it?
Come on, open up.
Beat it. Nobody gets in here.
All right, Frank, let's hit it. All right, stand right where you are. Hold on.
I'm not doing anything. What are you doing breaking in
here?
Get
your hands out funny.
Sure.
I'll shake him, Joe. He's clean.
Everything okay?
Yeah, Carl.
I'll get walking you in.
Who else in the house?
Nobody but the landlady. She's upstairs, her and her daughter. Nobody else here.
What's your name?
Pete Ellis.
Where's Russell?
I don't know any Russell.
All right, we'll look around. Come on. What's in there?
Dining room. There ain't nothing in there.
Open it up.
See? Nobody here.
No. All right, we'll check the other rooms. Where's this door go?
Bedroom. Ain't nobody in there.
Open it up.
Joe, nobody in the kitchen. Check the back. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.